Hi everyone. Today I would like to introduce you. Topic: Campbell-Stanley notation. Campbell and Stanley notation is a symbolic description of experimental designs. R in this description means random assignment into groups. Def line means no random assignment. X, experimental conditions, is introduced. OR means observation. And each row in this notation means refers into a different study groups. Example one. Researcher wishes to determine if maximum strength training improves endurance performance. He or she randomly assigns all participants into two groups, control and experimental groups. Both groups perform similar endurance training, but experimental group perform an intervention. Maximum strength training before and after the period of training, endurance performance for both groups were tested. And here is the Campbell-Stanley notation. R, both groups were randomly assigned, or observation one, X, this is row for experimental group means intervention, or observation two. R or one, no intervention, or two for control group. This design can be named pre- and post-test design. Example two, the same experiment can be done without random assignment. Subjects can be grouped based on their what club they attend or what college they attend. In this case, it would be observation one, X, observation two for experimental group. Remember, def line means random assignment, or one, no intervention, and or two for control group. Other examples are post-test only designed. This is true experimental study, but observations were done only after period of intervention for experimental group. Another example, repeated measures design. The same experiment, the same study can be done as repeated measures design. For example, but it can be done with one group. Observation one, then it would be, for example, just endurance training. Then it would be observation two. And then it would be endurance combined with strength training. Then test three. Another example, interrupted time series. When researchers do several tests, then period of intervention and several tests again. And more complicated example, randomization within non-equivalent groups. For example, the same experiment, we want to determine how maximum strength training improves elite skiers' performance, maybe collegiate skiers and junior skiers' performance. And we would take three different samples, randomize them into two groups, experimental and control. This would be, for example, elite skiers' experimental group, and this would be collegiate skiers, and this samples will be from junior skiers. In this group would be two subgroups, experimental and control groups, and experimental groups will perform strength training. And again, this was video about Campbell-Stanley notation. Thank you for listening. I hope this video was helpful.